Eden by obsessmuch. Read by SsjDeBusk. I don't own Harry Potter or Eden. Down to business. This is chapter 24, The Sin of Envy, and it is very short. So I'm going to try to read this in two readings. I mean, no side tangents. Oh, beware my lord of jealousy. It is the green-eyed monster which does mock the meat and feeds on. Oh, William Shakespeare, Othello. I'm counting all the stones that make up the wall that stands in front of me. It's vitally important that I count every last stone I see, because I won't think about what happened last night. I cannot let myself think about it. 55, 56, 57. God, did I really... How did I say that to him? What the hell was I trying to achieve? It makes my skin crawl just to think about it. To remember that look of pure fury on his face freezes my blood. 61, 62, 63. Never ever want to see him again. The mere thought of it makes me want to shrivel up and die. It's like a nightmare, a horrible, horrible bad dream. Maybe that's genuinely what it was. 88, 89, 90. Bloody awful. I felt bloody awful when I woke up this morning. I haven't seen Bellatrix or Drake or thing. God, Lucius. None of them have seen me. Been hoping that Bellatrix was so drunk that she couldn't remember what happened and drink. With him, I don't know what to hope for. Perhaps that he's too much of a coward to actually do anything about what he saw. Maybe he'll never mention it to his bloody aunt. Oh, and also that he'll never mention it to his bloody aunt. 104, 105, 106. Lucius. What can I possibly hope from Lucius? All I can hope for, I suppose, is that I never see him again. That he keeps away from me for the rest of my time here. That I never see him again for the rest of my life. That thought makes me feel so alone and abandoned and lost that I almost want to scream with it. The door swings open and I spin around. My heart moves into my throat. Maybe he's come. Finally, the door. There's not him at the door. Avery stands at the doorway, his calm, empty blue gaze sweeping around the room before it rests on me, critically taking in my pale, tired face. His own face holds absolutely no expression whatsoever. You have a visitor, he says quietly. He inclines his head slightly to peek at someone outside the door. Come along. And then the wonderfully familiar face of Ron appears into view. The boy tells me that you are occasionally out to see each other, Avery says, looking at me calmly. Is that correct? His voice is lower than Lucius's. It's funny, because I'm changing it. His voice is higher than Lucius's. It's like a light whisper. I'm giving him a low voice. Sorry. It's like a light whisper. It sounds like something that would come from a man far younger than what Avery looks like. He's looking at me. I think he sounds young when I read him. He looks at me for an answer and just gave it him stupidly. He has a small, tranquil smile. I assumed he was lying, judging from your expression. He just turns calmly to Ron, who pales slightly. Lying is not something I tolerate, Weasley. You should be aware of that. Ron sets his face hard, steeling himself. It's not a fucking joke, he says defiantly. You lie every day to keep... Day of your lives keeping your secret identities. Keeping your identity secret. Avery raises his wand calmly and points it at me. Crucian, damn it, Crucio. There we go. And no! Pain and fire and knives drill blades of acid tear through me over and over and over again, he lifts the curse. And suddenly aware that I'm on the floor, Ron's arms around me, they shake and shake, hurting with the shaking. Breathe and breathe. It's over. Keep it together. Ron's arms are shaking as they hold me. His breath is coming fast and shallow. Look up to see Avery, already turning to leave the room. I told you, Weasley. I won't hesitate to punish to your friend for your transgressions if necessary. He reaches the doorway and turns to face us again, his expression perfectly serene. But I don't see any harm in giving you a few moments alone together. Surely no harm can come from that. He pauses, his cold, empty eyes resting on me and Ron. After all, he says to himself, a humorless smile, what is life without affection? A spasm of fear runs through me as he backs out of the room, closing it behind him, leaving Ron and I alone together. I don't mind admitting it. Avery freaks me out. Creeps me out, I'm sorry. Not fear. I don't feel about him the cold dread I experience whenever I think about Lucius, but there's something so weird about him. I don't know what it is, but Ron stands up, pulling me up to my feet, by my shoulders, and looking up into my face. Are you alright? Yeah, shakily. I'm fine. I nod. I attempt a shaky smile. It's nothing I haven't been through before, after all. He doesn't smile back, which is really surprising. It's not as if it's really funny, is it? He frowns, not taking his eyes off my face. He looks as if he's afraid of what he's going to say. What happened to you last night? He asks quietly. When I went back to the dining room, you were gone and none of them would tell me where you were. My stomach crumples down when I remember humiliation, but I try to keep my face impassive. Nothing, I just... It's kind of embarrassing. I try a nervous laugh, but nothing comes out but a hysterical squawk. I had some wine to drink. You know, the wine we were serving. Anyways, I had a bit too much, and I know all about that. Ron interrupted me, surprising me. They were all laughing at me when I came back in. I want to know what happened when Lucius Malfoy disappeared from the room and didn't come back for the entire evening. I gulped down hard, trying to force my face, my fear back down my throat, where it spills out of me in words. I have no idea. I say firmly, Draco brought me up here and I fell asleep quite quick after that. If his father came up here, I didn't see him. Ron takes a deep breath through his nose. He's angry. I can tell. You can't be best friends with someone for 7 years without being able to tell when they're angry. Yeah, you can also not be friends with seven years without knowing when they're lying, Hermione. Oh, he says it in the next line. I'm so on top of the story. Look, he says defiantly. Despite whatever he thinks, Hermione, I'm not stupid. I know you're not wrong. And he nods, his lips a thin line. Then I want you to stop treating me as if I am. He looks directly into my eyes. What is going on between you and Lucius Malfoy? Ice grips around my heart, and I force myself to answer quickly. Honestly, it's nothing. It's not nothing, he says, his voice passionately resentful. I get the impression he's been wanting to say this for ages. It's not nothing! Then why do you always talk about him? Why do you spend all your time either talking about him or watching him? I've seen you! He says, his voice raising. Every time we're in a room with him, you spend half your time looking at him, and when you're not looking at him, he's looking at you. What's going on? Tell me the truth. I told you nothing. I say in my own voice, starts to rise out of desperation. You couldn't possibly understand. You're mainly left alone. But all I ever have in my life is Lucius tormenting me. And I'm scared, Ron. That's why I spend all my time looking out. And that's not even sort of true. Sorry. That's why I spend all my time looking out for him or talking about him. Because I live in fear of him every moment of every day. He grips on my shoulders tight. You don't need to be afraid of him. You don't need to be afraid of him. He murmurs furiously. Come here, Hermione. Remember when the basket was petrified you in the second year? Remember it? I asked him curiously. Of course I remember it. She's not saying anyways. The first horrible, unforgettable effect Lucius Malfoy had on my life. Ron nods, his eyes bright with emotion. I swore at that moment that I would always protect you. That I would never let anything else horrible happen. As horrible as that ever happened to you again. For a moment his eyes look as if they are about to spill over, and he turns from me quickly. But now, I feel like I'm losing him, he says quietly. I feel like he's taking you away from me. He has his hold over you, Hermione. You can't deny it. He takes a deep breath. Heaves his shoulders. And every day I feel you slipping further away from me. I look up at the back of him, his tall figure, topping off the mop of red hair. His ginger hair curls around the collars of his navy blue robe. He's grown stronger. Not longer, what? Okay, whatever. He's grown longer since he's been captured. Time was I could see the back of his neck above his robes. Not any longer. I know how lonely he feels. I know because it's how lonely I feel every moment of every day. But we don't have to be alone. I reach up and slip my fingers under his hair, curving them around the back of his neck as I walk around to face him. Before I know it, I'm doing what I Before I know what I'm doing, I'm stood up on the top of my tippy toes and I'm pressing my lips to his in a kiss. A kiss I've been waiting for 5 years. Isn't that adorable? I'm sorry. I'm out of control. And it's bubbling and it's nervous and it's sweet. And I feel slightly dizzy as he wraps his arms around me and lifts me slightly off the ground. My lips fall open, I start to giggle into his mouth. He breaks the kiss, laughing along with me. It's perfect. Everything it should be. He looks deeply into my eyes, and the pair of us are wearing little silly grins and almost seeing the sunshine again. Because in this moment, there's no pain, no hurt, no Lucius. There's nothing, just me and Ron and everything that's good in the world. He leans down and kisses me again. And I wrap my arms around his neck. And he lifts me off my feet once more. And then the door bangs open. We break apart hastily. And I turn to see the one person I don't want to see. The one person who I never, ever want to see me and Ron. Lucius stares at me from the doorway. His face is set hard, and the look on his eyes tears me to shreds. He's looking at me as if he hates me. This time he doesn't look like he simply hates me for what I am. This time he hates me because of what I've done. He narrows his eyes at the pair of us